For the past 2 weeks, we've been looking at Romans chapter 6 as part of our series, looking at great chapters of the Bible. And our series has taken us now all the way to verses 17 and 18 of this chapter. The first seven verses of the chapter were the first lesson to learn, which is you're not supposed to sin anymore because you are dead to sin now as a Christian. Then verses 8 through 15 gave us our second lesson to learn from this chapter, which is you're not supposed to sin anymore because you live for Jesus. Now we come to the third lesson to learn, verses 17 and 18, which is you're not supposed to sin anymore because you don't serve sin anymore. You serve righteousness. First of all, look at verse 18, where he says, being then made free from sin, you became servants of righteousness. Why am I not supposed to sin anymore? Because I am not a slave to sin anymore. I am a slave to Christ now, and I'm a slave to righteousness and to right doing, and not to sinfulness and wrongdoing anymore. How, though, is that possible? And it's because of verse 17. Notice the verse, it says, but God be thanked that you were servants of sin, but you have obeyed from the heart that form of doctrine delivered to you. I have now an upward look of thanksgiving. God be thanked. I don't serve sin anymore because I'm too busy being thankful for the grace of God. I have a backward look of remembrance. I used to be a servant of sin, and I can look back and see how that was not satisfying, how that was not helping me get to heaven, how that was condemning my soul to hell, how that was only leading me down a dark pit of despair. I have a backward look of remembrance. I don't want to go back there. I have an inward look of decision. I obeyed from my heart, an inward look of decision. I made a decision from my heart, not my blood pumper, my inward man. I made a decision to outwardly live for Christ. And I expressed that by believing in Him, repenting of my sins, confessing my faith in Him, being baptized into Him, and then Him taking away my sins. And it came about because of an inward decision, an inward look of decision, which then produced an outward look of obedience. I obeyed the form of doctrine. I obeyed literally the pattern of teaching. I was told specific things to do, and I did them. I was told to believe Jesus. I was told to repent to Jesus. I was told to confess my faith in Jesus. I was told to be baptized into Jesus. And now that I'm a Christian, I am told to be faithful for Jesus. Why? So that Jesus can come back and take me home to live with Jesus forever and ever and ever. Amen. So I'm not supposed to sin anymore. Will I make mistakes? Will I commit sin? Absolutely. And I have the free and available instant access to the throne of God as a Christian to ask for forgiveness and receive it instantly of those sins. But I'm a Christian now because by the grace of God, I obey Jesus Christ. I obey that form of doctrine, those commandments I was supposed to do. So I'm not supposed to sin anymore because I'm dead to sin. I'm not supposed to sin anymore because I am alive for Christ. I'm not supposed to sin anymore because I serve Him and not Satan. That is Romans chapter 6. Beautiful chapter. One of the most critical texts you can look at for understanding why it's essential that we are baptized. Jesus commands it, Mark 16:16. Paul explains why it is commanded. And so that's Romans chapter 6, a great chapter. We'll go back to the Old Testament and look at Ecclesiastes chapter 12 as part of our study of the great chapters of the Bible next month. Until then, thank you very much.